Andy Ruiz dropped Joshua four times. Even Klitschko just dropped Joshua once. Joshua was down four times and he was stopped in the seventh round. Anthony Joshua loses for the first time in 22 fights. God damn. Guys, I'm so upset. So Anthony Joshua finally tastes his first defeat. Guys, I don't know what to say, you know, I feel so heartbroken, you know. I feel like I just got dumped by my girlfriend, you know. And also, I'm happy for Andy Ruiz. He's the first Mexican-born heavyweight champion, you know. We knew that this guy was gonna have quick hands, you know. We all knew this, that Andy Ruiz has quick hands. But I didn't expect it to be that quick. This match was a classic, like speed versus power, and it just seems that power got overtaken by speed, and Andy Ruiz was just too fast for Joshua. The problem I saw with Joshua was he was trying to replicate a Klitschko performance, you know, like dropping his hands, jabbing and moving. But like when he first dropped Ruiz, he started being clumsy, you know. He just went in for the kill, whereas Klitschko would remain defensive and just look for the left hook or the right hand. But Joshua just wanted to finish him off. And knowing Andy Ruiz has never been dropped or stopped, you know, he's Mexican, he's got the Mexican heart. He went in there, gave it his all, dropped Joshua four times. Even Klitschko just dropped Joshua once. Joshua was down four times and he was stopped in the seventh round. It was a weird kind of stoppage, you know, and I didn't really like the referee. Guys, I don't know what referee they had. It was a weird kind of referee, you know. I thought I'll be expecting to see Tony Wicks, but I've never seen this referee before, you know. Like, he counted Joshua got up before the 10 seconds. But then he went back to his corner. And then the referee asked him, are you okay to continue? He said yes. But Joshua was being slow, trying to use like those methods, like to try and recover. Like if he was in the UK, he would get away with it. But in the US, like, the referee just waved it off, you know. It was a kind of weird stoppage, you know. So, Anthony Joshua, man. But the good thing is he has a rematch clause in his contract. So we expect around December, Andy Ruiz will go over to the UK to fight Joshua. Since yesterday, I've had a bad feeling, you know. I was just so depressed, you know. And I think like Joshua being like to the US, like he's used to the UK, like the energy is different there. And people weren't taking him as the champ, you know. So I think that really got to him, stuff like that, you know. And this is US debut as well. I'm not trying to make excuses for him, but you could just tell by his face that like he wasn't the normal Joshua, you know what I'm saying. But hey, everyone loses. I mean, like Mike Tyson lost, Muhammad Ali lost, Lennox Lewis lost, you know. Even Deontay Wilder lost to Tyson Fury. It was not a draw. Everybody knows this, right? So in life, you're gonna have to take some losses. You know what I mean? But guys, I just can't. I'm still not able to process what happened. I don't believe it. Joshua lost. I think Joshua was also like underestimating this guy, you know, because his physique is not the greatest, you know. He's got like man boobs, he's chubby as hell. But he can fight. He can fight. That's all that matters. He's in good shape, you know. To take out a guy like Anthony Joshua, you know, Joshua's an Olympic gold medalist, you know. Like, come on, bro. This guy is like, damn, he was like a 270 pounds, you know, like 270 pounds, you know. It's pretty chubby as well, you know, and it's pretty short. It's very, very short. Joshua got 8 inches reach on him. So, and he was a sneaky counter puncher, you know. So I think that's what happened to Joshua. But guys, this doesn't mean that Deontay Wilder is automatically beating Joshua, because like, you know, Joseph Parker beat Andy Ruiz, but Joshua beat Joseph Parker, you know. His styles make fights, that's what I mean. Do I still think Deontay Wilder can beat Joshua? I don't think so. But do I think Joshua can beat Tyson Fury? I don't know. Because right now, Tyson Fury is number one to me. And Joshua is number two. And then I think Deontay Wilder should fight Dillian the Body Snatcher White. Because he has to prove, you know, Anthony Joshua, it's not like Anthony Joshua was having an easy run, bro. Like, all his last 8 fights were all like the top 10 contenders, you know. Deontay Wilder's only fought like 3 top 10 contenders in his 40 wins. Like, come on, what the hell is that? You know what I mean? Yeah, and even Joshua said before the fight, like, fighting smaller guys is weird to him because he has to adjust. That's why he had his left hand down, you know. But man, I don't know how to say, guys. Just drop your thoughts in the comment below. Please subscribe if you're new. 10 post notification, guys. We'll stay in touch. I can't wait for the rematch. I just felt like I had to make this video, you know what I mean? So yeah, guys. Anthony Joshua, gracious in suffering his first defeat. No, but he's still well off, man. He's got like 100 million net worth now, like US dollars, you know. So he's well off. If I was Joshua right now, I'd think about like changing to acting career, you know, like, because people are gonna start hating, you know. I still like Joshua, you know. I knew that this day was gonna come, but I didn't expect it to come this early and against this opponent. Andy Ruiz is ranked like number 11 in the top, in the no, he's number 14 actually, I'm pretty sure, you know. So if you go on BoxRec, he's only 4 stars out of 5, you know. So I can't believe this. I'm still having a hard time processing it, guys. But keep your head up, guys. Anthony Joshua hopefully comes back, and this time he'll be in UK soil in the Wembley Arena, and it'll be a classic slugfest. This time I think Joshua should just go in for the kill. But he should be careful because Andy Ruiz is very quick in the first 3 rounds, you know, like he's got very fast hands for a big guy, you know. So yeah, guys, that's all I have to say for today.